गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे इज माय टॉपिक इज फ्री रेडिकल्स. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय फ्री रेडिकल्स? फ्री रेडिकल्स आर अ केमिकल स्पीशीज, एटम और आयन दैट हैज एन अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन इन एन ऑर्बिट एंड इज कैपेबल ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट एग्जिस्टेंस. सो इन फ्री रेडिकल्स देयर इज अनपेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन इज देयर. So this is a figure of unpaired electrode. The left side shows the paired electron, and the right one shows the unpaired electron. That is a free radical. Now, so when hydrogen radical is the hydrogen atom is the simplest radical because it contains only one electrons. So free radicals can be formed by loss or gain of single electrons from non-radicals. So, for example, superoxide species that is generated during the reductions of molecular oxygen that occur in the electron transport. And reactive oxygen species is the chemically most reactive species that contain the oxygen. Examples are hydrogen peroxides, which form by dismutation of oxygen or direct reductions of oxygen. So they are hydrogen peroxide, oxygen and hydroxyl ion. Now, so if we see that, so first is a molecular oxygen, then it is superoxide, and then hydrogen peroxide, and then hydroxyl ion, and gradually it forms the water. So what are the characteristic features of radicals? They are highly reactive, very short half-life, generate new radicals by chain reactions, cause damage to biomolecules, cells and tissues. Sources and generations of free radicals are, they produce normally and they produce by the environmental effects. So by biological processes, or you can say by cellular metabolism, they are by leakage of electrons from the respiratory chains, production of H2O2, hydrogen peroxide or oxidase, then due to chain reactions of membrane lipids, peroxidations, peroxisomal generation of oxygen and hydrogen peroxide, during the synthesis of prostaglandin, due to production of nitric oxides from arginine, during the course of phagocytosis, and in oxidations of heme to bile pigments. As a result of this auto-oxidation, so metal ion, iron Fe2+, and copper, ascorbic acid, glutathione, and flavin coenzymes is also formed. And first, we had seen about the cellular metabolism. Now come to the environmental effects. So what about the environmental effects as a result of drug metabolism? Examples of drug metabolism are paracetamol, halothane, cytochrome P450, then due to damage caused by ionic radiations, that is by X-rays, then photolysis of oxygen by light, photo excitations of organic molecules, cigarette smoke that generates free radicals, and alcohol promoting the lipid peroxidation. So there are two phases are there, sources and generation of free radicals, that is by cellular metabolism and due to environmental effect. Now, why we have in a question that free radicals are generally formed. So is there any importance of these free radicals in our body? Yeah, they have a very important role. They play an important role in defense mechanism, that is by producing macrophage and neutrophils with the help of phagocytosis. So By this, they destroy the infective agent. So it is important in defense against the microorganisms. That it is also helpful in signal transduction. That is shown in nuclear factor kappa beta signaling pathway, which is important in cell development, growth, and immunity. And the other important beneficial effect is due to mitogenic effect. Gene expression has also altered by free radicals, both deleterious and desirous manner. So, main important is that, so we had seen it is important in, free radicals have important functions in the body, that is by defense mechanism, by signal transductions, and by mitogenic effect. Now, lipid peroxidation, it is a chain reactions. It is formed by the free radicals. So what happened in this? So here what happened? The free radicals formed from unsaturated fatty acid, which initiates further the peroxidation. So polyunsaturated presents in the cell membrane are easily destroyed by peroxidations. So this free radical induced peroxidations of membrane occur in three phases, that is initiation, propagation, and termination. So what happened in this initiation? So during the initial phase, the primary event in the productions of R, that is radicals carbon center, radical carbon, of the PUFA, that forms a PUFA, or lipid peroxide radicals by interactions of PUFA molecules with radical generated. So here it forms a with reaction 1 and reaction 2, it forms a radicals, radical 1 and in reaction 1 and in reaction 2, that is lipid peroxide radicals. This R1 and this radicals, carbon centered radicals and lipid peroxide radicals, they are degraded to form a malon aldehyde. This malon aldehyde is estimated as an indicator of fatty acids breakdown by free radicals. Now come to the second phase, that is a propagation phase. What happened in propagation phase? This rapidly react with the molecule oxygen, forming the peroxyl radical, which can attack another polyunsaturated lipid molecule, that result in conversions of into hydroperoxide. Then this would leads to chain reaction. So one free radical generates another free radicals in the neighboring molecule, a chain reaction that is propagated here. So in the termination phase, what happened in termination phase? Lipid peroxidations proceed as a chain reaction until PUFA get oxidized. So in this, when if PUFA is not oxidized, the PUFA is oxidized up to the termination phase. So in the termination phase, what happened? The lipid peroxidation produced as a chain reaction until the PUFA get oxidized. So what happened here? The peroxyl radicals to form an inactive products. These inactive products are highly destructive. They are very destructive. They are destructive to the membrane, cells, and even the tissues. So this lipid peroxidations implicate lot of many disease. They are and the biomolecule. If we see the free radicals in the protein, they got oxidations of sulfhydryl. They got modification of certain amino acids like methionine, cysteine, histidine, and tryptophan. The net result is loss of biological activity of protein. So if you see the proteins, they cause oxidation of a certain group of sulfhydryl groups like methionine, cysteine, histidine, and tryptophan. So there is a modification of certain amino acids and loss of biological activity of proteins. Now come to the lipids. In the lipids, the polyunsaturated fatty acids are highly susceptible to damage by free radicals, that is lipid peroxidations. Though it will now in carbohydrate, what happens? In carbohydrate, it appears to be linked. It forms a hydrogen peroxide and oxaloaldehyde. When carbohydrate, it appears that linkage of carbohydrate to protein, that is glycation, in the increase of the susceptibility of protein to attack by free radicals is more. So what happened in that? The significance is that the character assumes that in diabetes mellitus, where protein glycation is associated with many health complications like diabetic microangiopathy, diabetic nephropathy. So in carbohydrate, we see that diabetic microangiopathy and diabetic nephropathy in case of there is a combination of protein and carbohydrate glycation. Now come to the nucleic acid. So in what happened in the nucleic acids? So in nucleic acid, free radicals may cause DNA strands, break fragmentations of bases and deoxyribose, such damage may associated with cytotoxicity and mutation. So in this three, so the mechanism involved in this disease, mostly three are they: damage to DNA strands, lipid peroxidation, and protein degradation. So there are three mechanisms for this. Now come to the diseases involved in this. So diseases, free radicals and the disease, mostly in cardiovascular disease, oxidized lipoprotein formed by the free radicals promotes the atherosclerosis. So this can be asked in a short note or you can in MCQ. Then inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis is a chronic inflammatory disease. So this can be produced by neutrophils. Neutrophil is a predominant causative agent for this. Then cancer, a free radical damage DNA cause mutagenicity and cytotoxicity. In cancer, it also promotes the this free radicals promotes the biochemical and molecular changes for the rapid growth of the tumor. Now come to the respiratory disease. So in respiratory disease, if lung exposures more than if lung is exposed to 100% of oxygen for long period, more than 24 hours, it leads to damage of endothelium, and that will lead to lung edema, and in children it will lead to bronchopulmonary premature newborn infants. Prolonged exposure of high oxygen concentration is responsible for bronchopulmonary dysplasia. And cigarette smoke, again, it attracts a neutrophil to the site which release more free radicals and leading to the lung damage. So we had now come to the diabetes. Destruction of islets of Langerhans due to accumulation of free radicals is one of the cause for pathogenesis of insulin-dependent diabetes mellitus. Now come to the cataract. So oxidative stress contributes to the cataract formation and mostly related to the aging. Male infertility is also reduced by sperm motility and viability. So free radicals also contribute in the male infertility. In aging process, free radicals are closely associated with various biochemical and morphological changes that occur during the ages. So other diseases also play a role in that affect by the free radicals. They are Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, multiple sclerosis, liver cirrhosis, muscular dystrophy, and toxemia of pregnancy. So if we see that, in general, if we see that, so we had seen that if we, in short, if we see free radicals, mostly inflammatory disease, then cardiovascular diseases, then cancer, respiratory disease, cigarettes, diabetes, cataract, male infertility, and aging process. This can be counteract. This free radicals can be this free radicals combat by the antioxidants. So this antioxidants are what? Antioxidants is a substance produced in sufficient quantity that neutralize the loan of electron of free radicals. So they are enzymatic antioxidants and they are non-enzymatic oxidants. So enzymatic oxidants are peroxidases like catalases, superoxide dismutases. Non-enzymatic oxidants are ascorbic acid, alpha tocopherol, glutathione, carotenoids, flavonoids, urates, and proteins. So this I had taken from Satyanarayan Vasudevan and this one. Now come to the xenobiotics. In your mind, what is xenobiotics? Xeno means what? Xeno is So xenobiotics is what? Xenos means what? Strange. So xenobiotics are the compound which may accidentally ingested or taken as a drug or compound produced in the body by bacterial metabolism. So what happened? Here detoxification term is also replaced by biotransformation, means xeno means any strange or any foreign compound, or you can simply metabolism of foreign compound, you can say directly. So this xenobiotics may be divided in two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. So phase 1 is mostly related to oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis, and phase 2 is a conjugation. Some compounds are go by phase 1, that is by oxidation, reduction, hydrolysis, then again they conjugated and then excreted in the urine. While in case of other compounds, they directly go for the phase 2 and they are excreted in the urine. So let's see phase 1. So phase 1 are oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis, and phase 2, that is a conjugation. That is conjugation with other compounds like glucuronic acid, amino acid, glutathione, sulfate, acetate and methyl group. Now, if we see that oxidation in phase 1 reactions, that includes alcohol, aldehydes, amines, aromatic hydrocarbons and sulfur compounds. Now, most of the oxidation reactions are detoxified, are catalyzed by monooxygenase, that is cytochrome P450. Now, come to the alcohol, oxidation by alcohol. So, aliphatic and aromatic alcohol undergoes to form corresponding acids. Ethyl alcohol forms acetaldehyde, then acetaldehyde forms the acetic acid and benzaldehyde forms the benzoic acid. So this is the oxidation of alcohol group. Now come to the aldehyde group. The aldehyde oxidize to produce corresponding acids. That is, benzaldehyde form the benzoic acid, coral form the trichloroacetic acid. So we had seen the oxidation by alcohol, by aldehyde. Now we will see the amine derivatives. What happened in amine? So here, aliphatic amines are converted to the corresponding acids and liberating the urea. And aromatic amino acids are oxidized to phenol. So aliphatic amino acids leads to aliphatic acids and urea and alanine and forms the para-amino phenol. Now come to the benzene. That is aromatic hydrocarbons. Benzene may oxidize to trihydroxyphenol. So benzene, this is the reaction for benzene. Now come to the sulfur compound. Sulfur compounds, organic sulfur oxidized to sulfuric acid. Drugs like meprobamate is a tranquilizer. It is oxidized to hydroxymeprobamate and excreted in the urine. Now this is now come to the reduction reaction. So we had seen the reaction in oxidation, that is by aldehyde, by amines, by aromatic compounds and by sulfur compounds. Now come to the reduction reaction. So in reduction is what? Picric acid is reduced to picramic acid. Para-nitrophenol is reduced to para-nitrophenol. The hydrolysis reactions here, now come to the third phase, phase 1 reaction, it includes oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis. Now we will see the hydrolysis. So in hydrolysis what? It includes the, there is a hydrolysis of bonds such as ester, glycosides and amide. There are three bonds are hydrolysis. They are ester, glycoside and amide. The examples are aspirin, isopropyl fluorophosphate and atropine. So acetylene, it forms the aniline plus acetic acid. Aspirin forms salicylic acid and acetic acid, and DFE, that is diisopropyl fluorophosphate, forms the dialkyl phenaldehyde and HF. Now, so we had seen this three compound phase 1. Now come to, that is oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis. Now come to the phase 2 reaction. In phase 2 reaction is what? That is a conjugation. So conjugation is what? conjugation in which foreign compounds combines with the substance is produced in the body. So they are conjugations, most common conjugation is the glucuronic acid. So if we see the conjugated compound here, so here types of phenol compounds here, and if conjugation with the glucuronic acid. So when glucuronic acid combines with phenols, the bond here is glucoside, and it forms a phenyl gluconide. And benzoic acid, it forms the ester. The bond here is the ester, and it forms the glucuronic acid monobenzoate. And now come to the bilirubin. Esters with the propionic acid side chain, glucuronic acid. Now come to the steroids. Esters with OH group here, and the glucuronide or steroids. Amide, the bond here is the amide and N-glucuride. N-glucuronide is the product. So here, if we see conjugation with the glucuronic acid like phenol, benzoic acid, bilirubin, then steroids and amines, they form the respective component. Now come to the conjugating other agents. Other than glucuronic acid, that is sulfate. It forms a phosphoadenosine phosphosulfate. Cysteine, that forms the glutathione. And acetic acid forms the acetyl-CoA. These are the active form of conjugating agent. Now, so we had seen the phase that in xenobiotics, there is a phase 1 and phase 2 with the reactions, oxidation, reduction and hydrolysis. As we know, so this oxidation, if the products are not oxidized, then they go for the conjugation and they are excreted in the urine or feces. Then other one, xenobiotics by phase 2 reactions. We had seen the free radicals also. In this free radicals, they are unpaired electrons. They are chemical species of unpaired electrons. Remember the terminology, we want unpaired electron in the orbit. Chemical species, that is, it may be atom, it may be ion, or it may be molecules that has an unpaired electron in an orbit, that is called a free radicals. So we had seen this free radicals, how they form in here molecular oxygen, then superoxide, then it forms a hydrogen peroxide by adding this and forms a hydroxyl ion and then excreted in the water. So we had seen this free radicals and xenobiotics. So this xenobiotics can be asked as a full, can be asked as a short note or as a full questions, and that will be asked in phase 1 or phase 2 reactions, and in free radicals is also asked some of in MCQs, and what are the benefits in MCQs and even in short notes.